Welcome to Insurgency Sandstorm. Today, we're going to take a look at the Demolitions class. I will show you everything that you need to know so you can start blowing shit up. A Demolitions unit can help your team in many ways. You can destroy objectives in certain game modes to help your team win the game. In the previous Insurgency game, this was vitally important because players needed to throw or shoot explosives at a cache to destroy it. In Sandstorm, caches cannot be rigged to explode by any member of the team. You might think that this will render the Demolitions class obsolete, but it really doesn't. Pressing and holding Foxtrot to rig a cache and receive a detonator takes time. A person can get shot while he is busy doing this, so it's not an ideal situation. As a Demolitions guy, you will have access to all kinds of explosives that can destroy an objective almost instantly. Fuel trucks can even be destroyed with the rocket fired from a safe distance. C4s or IEDs can simply be thrown into a room with a destructible objective and then you can detonate those. You can even throw it in the room and blow up all the guys who are inside. This will allow you to complete the objective without even exposing yourself to enemy gunfire. You are not limited to destroying objectives as a Demolitions unit. You can also destroy vehicles very quickly. It is very risky to point your gun at an enemy firing a mounted machine gun from behind a truck unless you're sniping from a safe distance. A Demolitions unit can simply destroy this vehicle and the enemies around it with one well-placed RPG. It is much quicker and it is very satisfying to pull off. Use your lean function to align your RPG for a good shot. It will not only help you by limiting your exposure, but it can also help you to make your shot more precise. You will not be able to bring along many rockets, so use the lean function and make every shot count. You are your team's best hope for survival when the enemy commander calls in a helicopter. Choppers can be destroyed using rockets that only the Demolition class has access to. Without you, the rest of your team is forced to take cover, and they will have a very hard time stopping the enemy from capturing the objectives. You can always use your explosives to kill people. C4 can be strategically planted near entrances or objectives. Just make sure that you are a safe distance away when you detonate it. C4s and IEDs have a very big blast zone and you could kill yourself if you're not careful. Mines can be planted on the road to stop enemies from driving over it, and they can be shot to prematurely detonate them. Incendiary grenades can be thrown into rooms to flush out the enemy, or you can even block off a certain part of the map for a short period of time. Even if the fire disappears, the remaining heat is still very lethal. The hardest part about playing the Demolitions class is creating a good loadout for it. The explosives that are exclusive to this class have high supply point costs, and they are very heavy. Other classes, like the Marksman and the Rifleman, have plenty of room to customize their primary weapons exactly the way they want them to be, but you will have to balance things out. The AKM and the M16A4 are great weapons for the Demolitions class. These two weapons are well-rounded assault rifles that can be customized for just about any situation. It is important for the Demolitions class to learn how to control your weapon using cheap attachments or none altogether. Even if you decide to go for higher cost weapons like the G36K or the M4A1, it might be much easier to optimize your loadout if you're capable of winning firefights without spending too many points for the weapon attachments. The points you save can be spent on things like armor, carriers, pistols and of course more explosives. I will give an example of a loadout for the Demolitions class. For the primary weapon, we will pick the AKM, it only costs us 3 points. We will equip an OKP7 sight for 1 supply point to acquire targets more easily. To reduce the recoil of this weapon, we will attach a foregrip for 3 supply points. We will pay 1 more supply point to equip light carrier, so that we have more ammunition and grenades. We will pay another supply point for light armor, so we don't die too fast, at least we have some sort of defense. An RPG-7 costs about 4 points, but this is necessary and it is a rocket launcher that can be fired twice. A grenade costs 2 supply points, but it can be used to flush enemies out of a room. In case our enemies use chemical smoke, we will equip a gas mask, since for this class it is free. All of these things combined, it makes for a pretty decent loadout for just 15 supply points. If you can't control the recoil of the AKM, then you can leave that foregrip at home. And then you have 3 extra points to spend on your loadout. For example, you can now go for an IED instead of just grenades, for just 1 extra point. And at the same time, by spending 2 points, you can upgrade to heavy armor, which will keep you in the fight much longer. Whatever you decide, it's based on your personal preference and on your skills and your comfort with some of these weapons. If you're carrying multiple explosives, then it might be tricky to immediately swap to your second explosive. There is a trick that will make your life a lot easier. If you double tap the button that you assigned to select your first explosive, then it will instantly select the second one. This will save you a lot of time. Let me know in the comments what you think about the Demolition class. And by the way guys, YouTube likes and shares are very helpful to me. If you think that this video is worthy, would you mind taking a moment to like and share this video? If you haven't done so already, then make sure to subscribe. This was Fog of Gaming, thanks for watching, and I will see you in Sandstorm.